The harvest is truly white. It's ready for picking. God need more qualified laborers in the field. Our problem, we're still stuck inside church doors trying to tell people how good we are with the talents we got, whether to take it to the streets. You got to take it to the streets. And you got to know that you got to be the right kind of seed, that it don't be like the seed sower said. A man went out to sow seed. The word of God came with your ability, with your talent. And the minute you got out there, it fell on hard. It fell on stocky. It fell on rocky. It fell on stony. And guess what? The cares of the world came and snatched the seed out of you. The Bible declares decrees according to the book of Psalms. It said in Psalms 1, blesses a man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stand in the way of the sinner, nor sit in the seat of the scornful. But his life shall be in the law of the Lord. And his law does he meditate day and night. You got to get someone to get stuck. You got to get someone to get planted. People who jumping up around all the time, they can't bear no fruit. The same thing Jesus said about that fig tree when in the Bethel. It bared no fruit, and it's supposed to bear fruit during that season. But what happened? It was naked. It was unpunishable, because I believe that tree was an example to most of us. We are a tree, but we don't bear no fruit. And I'm not trying to be a fruit inspector toward anybody. There's a time that you got to get yourself somewhere just stuck. You got to get rooted in the word of God. And you got to believe that God's got a plan that supersedes far beyond more than you can imagine or think of. You got to hear me, ladies and gentlemen. This is not a word to come and get you to bash you, but it's a word to help you. We're living in perilous times now, according to 2 Timothy 3. We are, and we don't understand what's going on in our lives. We got all kind of men of God talking before, saying all kind of things before, and yet we run ourselves to death with them, and we're not what we're supposed to be, only because we feel like that's what we think we should be. And the first thing to come out, well, that's what the Lord told me. No, he didn't. You told yourself that you wanted to be that way so bad that you didn't understand that God had you in the right place the first time, but you kept praying over and over, and God gave you what you wanted. That's what you wanted to be, and that's what you're going to hang out at? Okay, you got to deal with whatever comes out of it. And that's just the way it is. Rebellion would be the biggest thing to kill you in the body of Christ. God will give you the desires of your heart. And that was the desire of your heart. God had you in the right place with the right people at the right time, but you didn't have no stick-to-itism. You went out and ran around, and you prayed that God had seen you in the right place. He had you in the right place all the time. I call that strictly rebellion, trying to find another place to go because you don't want to be in the leadership of the one you're in. You got to hear me. I'm not just talking. I'm telling you the truth. And you don't want to hear this. You want to hear some good, nice, pleasurable measure to make your ears tickle, to make you feel good. And I'm trying to give you straight up biblical information about what we're dealing with, the times we're in. The Bible said, well, the time is at hand. Now, you don't know the time, place, when the Son of Man will come. I am Pastor Charles Ellis here at Harvest New Light Church and Harvest New Light Studios. To the woman of God, co-pastor Patty Ellis. Hats off to my beautiful mother, who I know God's going to heal her. I got the faith to believe. My sister, my auntie, and God's miraculous power and healing power is all in place for them. God bless you and God keep you. Thank you for joining me here at Harvest New Light Church. And I hope to get a chance to talk to you guys on Saturday morning with my Psalms report.